Hey guys, so I just wanted to come before you guys briefly to talk about the keys to healing faster from anything. And this was kind of prompted because I'm in quite a few groups, but I'm in this fibroid group that these posts have been mind-boggling to say the least. And I shared a comment on what to eat, you know, to get out of pain, to reverse this or that. And I've had a few people respond and say, one meal a day, only eat fruits and vegetables, that can't be healthy. And so I want to set the record straight because we are frugivores and we should not be eating a bunch of cooked food. We should not be consuming the amount of food that we do on a daily basis. We do not give our organs and glands a rest enough. And this is why we deal with so much dis-ease, right? And it came to me in the shower today. Like, people are always saying, oh, this person was perfectly healthy and they died of this and they were perfectly, there's no such thing as being perfectly healthy, okay? And there's no such thing of having health in your body, optimal health in your body simultaneously with dis-ease, all right? So we need to understand the correlation between the foods that we eat and the disease we have in our bodies. So that's what I wanted to start off by saying, because that's what prompted this video. So quickly, one of the first things that you want to do when you are sick with anything, and that is you want to abstain from foods that are acidic and mucus forming. First thing. Do not bring in any offending foods. That's the issue. We violate nature every single day by bringing in foods that don't serve us, that bring acid to our body, that dehydrate our bodies, right? And as you've heard me say before, many times before, you cannot rehydrate the human body with water. It doesn't work like that. Fruit will rehydrate the human body, the highest vibrational food on the planet that the body pulls water from, structured water, H2O3, to rehydrate the body. That is how you rehydrate a human body. And oftentimes when you're sick, you're dehydrated. You're also dehydrated. So you want to abstain from foods that are acidic and mucus forming. You want to stay away from diets that are high in fats and proteins. So no meats, no dairy, no starches, no grains, no eggs, none of it. It is not food fit for human consumption. We are truly frugivores at the root. That is what our species should be eating. Anything outside of that, we're welcoming in disease. Okay? So while we're doing this, right? Fasting, abstaining from foods, take in fruit juices, cold pressed fruit juices. Still drink water, at least 2 liters a day. I'm not against water. What I'm saying is most of us are so acidic, our body uses the water as a buffer for the acids and you pee it right out. So if you're in the bathroom 30 minutes to an hour within drinking water, your body's not utilizing it, okay? And it's definitely not rehydrating you. So when you abstain from foods, I'm sorry, my dog keeps jumping on my lap. When you abstain from foods, right, that are mucus forming and acid forming, and you up your fruit juice intake, cold pressed juices, even you can do some fruit and veggies. It's not going to be as high as vibration as fruit only foods, which is going to help cleanse, which is going to rehydrate, which is going to cause you to poop. You want to do that. You want to get the toxicity out. You want to get the waste out. Okay. That's what's going to rehydrate you, excuse me, and rest. The body heals best when it's at rest. These are things you have to do for yourself. You cannot be sick and still be out and pushing and doing this and doing that and not allowing your body the opportunity to rest. That is how you run yourself down. That is how you stay sick, my dear. So it's time to start focusing on proper self-care, especially when you're sick. All right. So fruit juices, they're going to be the highest vibrational food on the planet. You can do fruit and veggie. I like apple, carrot, beets, and sometimes ginger. That's a great juice if you're going to have a fruit veggie drink, okay? Sometimes you can throw celery in there. Cucumbers are great. Anything that's high in water and that's going to be rehydrating. The other thing that you want to do is sweat. Sweat, 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 sweat. Your skin is your largest eliminative organ. It is your third kidney, if you will. And so when the other two kidneys are not filtering as they should, your skin will do that, right? So you, a lot of people don't sweat because they have thyroid issues, right? So you want to induce a sweat. You want to give a sauna-like experience. Take a very, very warm bath to make you sweat toxins out. Put bentonite clay, put dead sea salt, Epsom salt in the bath. Things that are going to help you remove the toxins from your body, right? So sweating will help remove toxicity and it will help you to get well and to recover faster, right? You can also be taking in warm or hot herbal teas, things that are going to continue to get your chi moving, speeds up the healing process, right? So I also like superfoods. Add those to your juices. Add that to water, right? Or superfood, whole food supplements that are gonna get in there and help speed up that healing process because it helps to regenerate the body, just like fruit helps to restore the body. The particular superfoods that I'm talking about happen to be grown in regenerative soil, so you're getting all of the vitamins, minerals, trace minerals, everything that your body needs in order to heal. So you always want to work with your body, aid your body in the healing process. Whenever we're experiencing something like a virus, any kind of sickness, a flu, a cold, that is our body's way of saying, hey, I need to detox. Hey, I need some detoxification over here. It's calling out for your attention. It's your body's language. Pay attention to it so that you can do the things that you need to do to aid it in healing. Okay. And no stress as best you can, because I know that some of our stressors live with us. Okay. So as best you can, stay stress-free. Anger is acidic. Joy is alkaline. Find calming music to listen to. Music is vibrational, does different things. Research that. So herbal teas, superfoods, no stress. Fasting will always allow the body for faster healing. You must give your organs and glands a rest. It's a must. And you must do it often, not when you get sick. That's the key. Fast often. A mono meal for one whole day is fasting. Working yourself up to being able to do a water fast for a whole day. Working your way up past that to do dry fasting where you consume nothing. That is where your body takes that is where the greatest healing takes place in your body. So you have to learn how to fast properly. You have to learn the art of fasting and why it is so beneficial to your health. But fasting is going to always allow the body to heal faster. And when you give your organs and glands a rest, that energy that would have normally gone to digesting food can now go towards healing your body. And I'm going to stop there. Peace, love, and wellness. I'm going to see you guys in the next video.